Tuesday is Early Favor Hour Storytelling Edition. And we're going to be telling story, but we are going to be bringing out some stuffs in the story. And I can say that it's in sync with some of the things that you have heard before now. Story. There was a particular time a seminar was being held, and the one conducting the seminar, the facilitator, all of a sudden, in trying to drive home the message, he paused and got balloons already blown out. There are 50 people in the class, so he got 50 balloons and now gave them marker to write their names on each of the balloons that have been given to each of them. And all of them wrote their names on the balloon. Then he got all those balloons thrown into just one room, a room. Just threw all of them into the room. And I told them that all of them should go and look for their own, the one that has their own name. And he was giving them 5 minutes. Since they wrote their name on their own balloon, and they went into the room, there was frantic pushing around, trying to locate the one that is there among the 50. They tried, they was only to see another name, push it aside. For 5 minutes, none of them could locate the one that belonged to them. They say, okay, no problem. What I want you to do now is that anyone you locate, call the owner and give to the owner. Within a few minutes, all of them have gotten their balloon. I now told them that that is the mystery of finding happiness in life. What's the topic? Finding happiness. Many times we are frantic in trying to find happiness, not minding the happiness or the unhappiness of other people. It doesn't work like that. In fact, life has been built, has been designed, that the more people you help to find the happiness, the more likely the happiness you will be getting in return. It does not mean from them. That is how life has been built. Let's get the key that unlocks the doors that we are knocking aimlessly to open to us. You want happiness? How many people are you making happy? They were all looking for their own. It's okay. But they were, and each one of them, at this point in time, there was somebody's balloon that they could see. It's not my own. It's not what I'm looking for. But you have gotten something that you can use to be a blessing to somebody. And then let one problem in the world be solved through you, no matter how minute. And that is the law that has held this world together. The law of what you give comes back to you. Luke chapter 6, 38. Give, and what will happen? It shall be given unto you. Good measure, press down, shaking together, and running over, shall men give unto you. Imagine, again, that is how. Why don't we pay attention to this often spoken and read law of God? It's the law that holds so many things together. Finding happiness, this is how it is. In the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 8, in that particular scripture, I call out a knowledge. What you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. That is the knowledge I got from this. Knowing that whatsoever good thing a man doeth, the same shall he receive of the Lord, whether he be born or free. When you read this scripture very well, the same shall he receive of the person. No, the person I gave him good something, did not even return. You are so myopic in your thinking. It is not the best. Don't be organized anyhow, any which way from it must come back to you. That is why people that do good and have this, they don't mind if you don't return it. They know that it will come back to them to another one that they will not even be mindful of returning. Hence, it does not stop them. Either you return their own good, knowing that it is God that brings it back to them. You are finding happiness. In the service yesterday, we talked about practicing joy. Can you remember some of the things that we said? We said that decide very early to rejoice. Another thing we said was that you should be an extension of somebody else's joy. Somebody has gotten promotion that, you know, buy lunch. For two of you or three of you, let's celebrate your... It's the other way around. Yeah, God, what are you going to beg for? Do it. You, even though you two are trusting God for something that are not... Celebrate. The person, that memory you are giving to the person will also be your own memory. And anytime you do something good, you have a sense of fulfillment in you. I've made somebody happy. And you two, any time that you go to your bed, you keep on replaying that. It keeps coming back to you. Very important. Joseph, he was in the prison. He was helping people in the prison. He got into one of the spaces one day in Genesis 40, 6 to 8. He saw two guys that were unhappy. He went to meet them. You people cheer up now. Why are you unhappy? He should be unhappy because they threw him in his prison. He did not do anything to the brother. Some people live their life like that. Why should I encourage somebody when Mr. I need the encouragement? Wrong way. How will you not get the encouragement you need when you are not reaching out to people in the one that you can do? We are not saying that you should do more than yourself. You can the open heaven of today, hospitality. When this message come to me yesterday, I did not know what was in your plate, but I have already woken up today. You can see the first minister that spoke is, see what God is speaking at the time like this. Many of us, we have found ourselves in point of need because we are not mindful of other people. The gate man around us, we are not mindful. The somebody, a messenger, that cleans your office, you can be a blessing to the person in the little world. How much do you take to go and get your lunch? And my lunch is 250 naira. I'm going to give you 300 naira today. Okay, madam, thank you. You are be a blessing to somebody. Oh, you may have people, we are not even mindful of it. And it will be trapping our own. Joseph, he was suppressed of his heart because of the situation, but he was bringing solutions to other people. And Joseph came in unto them in the morning and looked upon them, and behold, they were sad. Continue. And he asked Pharaoh's officers that were with him in the wall of his lord's house, saying, wherefore look ye so sadly today? Now, why? We cheer up. And they said unto him, we have dreamed a dream, and there is no interpreter of it. And Jesus said unto them, do not interpretation belong to God? Tell me them, I pray you. Let me be a solution to your own situation. Even though my own, I'm in a situation that I don't know who will. That is the way life, God has ordained life. And you know what? God made his own situation to be resolved. When you read the book of Genesis chapter 41, verse 1, Pharaoh had a dream. Who gives drink to people? God. Meaning that the thing that led to his own release, his own situation of being released, God did. That's why that knowledge is what will make happen to others. God will make happen. He will still use men, but it will be God because he must heal you back. Very important. Naaman, when you read the book of 2 Kings chapter 5 verse 1, 2 Kings chapter 5 verse 1, the Bible says that Naaman, through him, deliverance has come to Syria. He was bringing deliverance to people and to the nation. But if he needed deliverance, he was a leper. At the end of the day, God organized his own deliverance because no man could help him. Now, Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable, because by him the Lord has given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. By him, the Lord has given deliverance unto Israel. By him. He needed deliverance, but he did not suffer. I'm not going to any war, even though I can fight. My situation is not okay. No. In verse 14, 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 14. God himself organized his own deliverance, because through what happened, it was God that did it for him. Then went he down and dipped himself 7 times in Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God, and his flesh came again like unto the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. A little child will not have some of these spots that a little child baby is without blemish, and at an advanced age of that he had, yet was having the skin of a little child. What you make happen, don't keep on talking and thinking about your own need. Think about what you can do for somebody. I'm giving you the keys that can take you out of your situation. Many of us, we think that we are disadvantaged, but there are some people that are lower than you. 50 naira can be a blessing to somebody. At least a child can be happy. You can buy biscuits. Do something. Be a blessing to some. That is how some of us say that nobody is giving to us. Why? Because you have not been mindful of what other people do. And those people will be giving to another person right beside you. Because something will just block them from not doing it. Because you have not seen that. Don't blame them. Enough for you to say, no. Okay, this day, I must ensure I bring joy, I bring happiness to some. Pick up your call, pick up it, your text, your phone. Send loving message. You want love. Say, I appreciate you in my life. If they don't come back immediately, but God will organize it. You will know somebody that is going through something. Just send, comfort them. Be a blessing to them. And you will see that it will keep on coming back to you. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 4, 13 to 17. 2 Kings chapter 4, there was a particular woman, the Shunammite woman. She did not have a child, but she was wealthy. And she was always telling the husband, this man of God, Elisha, anytime he came to the city, I used to see him hanging around. After he has done the crusade, he would just hang around one corner and be sleeping by the horse before morning will come and he will go. Why don't we build a little chamber? At this speed, we have the means. The other man said, no problem, if you want to do that, it's your money, you are wealthy. And she built a chamber, put a table there, put a bed there, and told the man of God, sir, please, anytime you come to this city to minister, you can come to our house, there is a place for you. And she will put food there, she will put... After a while, the man has been doing that. All of a sudden, the heaven just fell on the man and told the man, this man, the woman must receive something. She was not doing it because she wanted to receive anything. In fact, when the man of God called her, what do you want me to do for you? She said, I want nothing. Do you want me to speak to the king or to the captain? He said, this man does not know that I'm very influential. I'm very popular in this. He said, no. Is there not anything at all? Not she not even mentioned that she don't have a child. In her mind, she has even let her that side. So that situation made me to realize she was not expecting anything. She just wanted to be a blessing in the path of that best her financially. Okay, let me meet somebody's need and leave it. But God now made her own that area of her deprivation. Even though she was not now asking, God now made it to happen. 2 Kings 4, 13 to 17. And he said unto him, say now unto her, behold, thou hast been careful for us with all this care. What is to be done for thee? Wouldest thou be spoken for to the king or to the captain of the host? And she answered, I dwell among my own people. I have my own connection. Continue. And he said, what then is to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, verily, she has no child, and her husband is old. 15. And he said, call her. And when he had called her, she stood in the door. And he said, about this season, according to the time of life, thou shalt embrace his son. And she said, nay, my lord, thou man of God, do not lie unto thy handmaid. 17. And the woman conceived and bare a son at that season that Elisha had said unto her, according to the time of life. There are some times your doubt self be no more matter. You no more matter by the reason of the seed that you have sown. Your unbelief. There are some things that have come to discover that cancels unbelief and doubt. Which God said that without it, no man will receive, will please God. But you can, you want happiness, give happiness. Extend happiness to others. This message has come to us 2-3 times today. In the open heaven of today, that the Jew was talking hospitality to people. That was how Sarah and Abraham, they saw three men. They did not know that they were angels, but they accommodated them. Before those one went, they prophesied. And you can go through the scripture like that. People that are very hospitable. Be hospitable. Bless somebody. Go through your wardrobes. Check some things that you don't use. I do that regularly by God's grace. That you don't use, that are okay. And start giving out. Get to your store. And the thing is that as I've been doing it, my wardrobe does not contain my clothes. And I've told us 90 something percent of the clothes, the shoes, the watches that I'm being blessed by them. I'm not begging for them. People even beg me to give to them. Anytime they are traveling, wow, Pastor, one elderly woman travel, he said, Pastor, I do not when I asked you the last time, you said that anything. Just tell me something. Okay, what's your size? What? People, it will be coming back. It's not because I'm a pastor, it's because I give to. There are many pastors that will not be having this kind of testimony. Give. That is you, he has given cars before. There was a time he told us that he gave 12 cars. Things don't just come to people. Because he's an empowerment of God. What of other men of God that are strugglers? Be an extension of God's happiness to somebody. Even though things are not okay with you, make somebody okay. The gate man, your friend, just be, celebrate with them. Be just with them. Encourage somebody. See yourself. Encourage, even though you are in the same situation. Encourage the person. Whatever you can do, let me help you. Is there anything I can do? God is watching, and God will now organize your settlement. Can we rise to our feet and pray and say, Father, please help me to be a blessing to as many people as I can within the power of my hand. Help me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, we ask that all of us should be here. Sometimes we get overwhelmed and carried away by our needs, that even when we have seed to sow around us, we are even neglect the seed and the seed just rot away. Please help us to be conscious of this so that we will not organize our own deliverances by yourself. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let me God our offering and bless the name of the Lord. We